Yeah, it really, really, really sucks that I died on fucking 44 and now we can't get past fucking first 10. It's just ridiculous. All I had to do was 6 more fucking levels and then never do it, like, never do an all fucking boss run again. And then it was like, fuck no. You're fucked. Reset and fucking grind this out. Fire up, man. I'm back in. Oh, I didn't know that. Should definitely add that. But I don't know what to delete. I don't know which emote to throw on. Is it like a sub emote or is it a... Yeah, it's a sub emote. Yeah, you're lucky you get to see this, because I was about to be done with it, but then I died on stage 44, so now I'm continuing. Thank you. still have to see. Alright, let's just keep it rolling here and then finish it. Yeah, I know what the glitch is, but it's not really useful when you die. Trying to use it, so I don't find it super useful. Yeah, I know about the bomb glitch, but it's not super useful. Like, it can be useful, but not if you kill yourself with it. Only 45 more levels to go, and I had 7 not too long ago. Got to 44 and then entered the door too early without just running on the blocks. Shit. I think just Cyfrog just likes the music in this game. Well, it's a 52-minute run for any percent, but nobody's done all blocks and all items, which is why I just want to do that first and then worry about any percent. Yeah, there is no all blocks run that I'm aware of. Nobody has the patience. Cyfrog is getting down to the psychedelic track. Psychedelic trance audio, radio, all in view. Yeah. Getting freaky in the corner there. What's going on? Let's just grab the bomb, I guess. Yeah, let's just keep this running and roll with it and not fuck it up. I'm gonna be more careful with just going crazy when there's no door. Drugs Bunny, he plays with his monkey balls. He doesn't know about that bomb yet. With his donkey balls, man. Oh, did I really just do that? Please. Party! Yay! A balloon party! What is this, a red split? It's, I'm item is the last thing I fucking remember. It's a useless item.
Is this the RPG and I'm a super bomber, man? God. So fuck off.
Oh, you didn't know about the Super Bomberman 2 remix?
Remix! That unmatched ruggedness!
Yeah, I was gonna put together a full album with me remixing Bomberman songs. Like, just take all of the Bomberman songs and, like, make an album out of it with, like, Roland the vocals on top of. You'd have the Roland Deep vocals on top of classic Bomberman things, which goes like really well with rap, honestly. Like, the Bomberman songs are like perfect for rapping over, honestly. So perhaps when I'm done with my Bomberman grind of speedrunning him, I'll put together a full album. I think that would be dope as fuck. I just put together like a full album, like a full length, like out, like multiple bonus tracks. Like with this song right here, it'd be a solo single, solo album with just me rapping over all the good Bomberman tracks, every Super Bomberman theme out there, the Bomberman Hero songs and stuff. I could do like a complete single for each one, honestly. Each game would have like its own soundtrack remix. And just be like, rolling deep with that unmatched ruggedness. Like, I'll probably... I might get into that project after the Bomberman speedruns are completed. I'm just pretty heavy in trying to get as many records as I... Or, have as many... Oof! Let's not die here. As many world records as I can in the Bomberman. Like, let's say, you know, I could have a soundtrack for Super Bomberman 1, and I could have all the songs on it, every, like, you know, the whole soundtrack to Super Bomberman would have, a track that I would do as well. I mean, you could have the whole thing, and I would just be dropping mad hits. That's something I would like to get back into. The main pro- I just don't have, like, the hype that I... Like, I'll get it back again. If I get all these records, like world records in this game, in Bomberman, it'll give me the motivation to want to, like... It'll give me that fire to something to rap about, you know? But I'm too bit, like, I'm pretty bent on, like, speed, just at least doing a run for each Bomberman game in each category at the moment, which I'm getting really close. Like, I would say I'm over halfway there. I'm over halfway done with the Bomberman project that I've been doing, which is to speed run all the Bomberman games. The mixtape. Yeah, I really wanted to put together a Bomberman album. I have songs that I can already use for it and whatnot, but Bomberman 64. I don't have my N64 with. If I'm doing Bomberman 64, I'm doing it on console, and I don't have. The reason why you haven't seen Bomberman Hero, which I really, really, really want to do. Like, Bomberman Hero is one of my favorites. I would be playing the shit out of that. But it emulates really poorly on Wii. On VC, it's really bad. And that's the version I have it at the moment. I wouldn't want to do serious RTAs on a shitty, you know, version of the game. So, I need to get my N64, and then I need to get the Japanese version of Bomberman 64, which I don't have. I picked up Bomberman Jetters on the GameCube, and it's the Japanese version. And it should work on my Wii, because it's modded, but the problem is the disk driver doesn't work, so I have to get that fixed, and then I'll be playing that. But I'm saving the best stuff for last. I'm saving all the best games for last. I'm getting the shit out of the way, like this all blocks shit. Getting this out of the way. And then I can focus on the hardcore games. Okay, of course the door would be there. But once I'm done speedrunning Bomberman, I think... Like, my next projects would be the Dragon Ball Z games. Those are really good. I really enjoy the DBZ games, so I think I'm going to get back into those. That and Final Fantasy stuff. Which I might do on the side with some of these games, because it's getting to the point where a lot of the Bomberman runs that I'm going to be doing, it's going to be really, really, really tough for me to get the times that I want to get, so it's going to be a really tough grind, so I probably would want to have a sub-game to play, you know, like a Final Fantasy game or something to do on the weekends or something, and then, like, maybe, you know, Dragon Ball Z or something when I get salty, because I'm going to get salty with the games that are coming up, because I'm going to want to get, like, record for... Dude, I want to pick up a Saturn. I want to get a Sega Saturn. Apparently Hidokage was going to give me hers, but I don't think it has any, like, cords, or it's just, like, the console, so I have to get the plugs for it, I have to get the controllers for it, and then I have to get the games for it. I don't think she has any games for it. Bomberman 64 is in the list, though. It's in the list. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna play Bomberman 64 and speedrun it when it comes up. But it's just, it's a really, really technical game, and it would, I would spend months and months on it, honestly. Like, when I get into Bomberman 64, I'm probably gonna play it for several months. It's not gonna be like, Bomberman 64 is not gonna be a game that I'm just gonna pick up and be done with, like, after a few runs. I'm gonna sit there and do several runs, and of each category too, like 120 cards. All the categories I would do for it as well. I'll probably start with the 100% category. That's been working pretty well, because I learn more about the game when I do 100%, and then I do the any percent run. Like, with Bomberman Tournament, for example, I did the 100% first, and then switched over to any percent, and it was a breeze. Like, when I, because I knew a lot about the game after I did 100%. Mr. Bones. There's a lot of really good games on the Sega Saturn, to be honest. That's a system that's really under. I actually want to pick one up. Like, the games that I've seen for it, they're really colorful. It's just an amazing system. And it has a lot of games that I would like, for sure. But the main reason why I'd be picking it up is for Saturn, Bomberman Saturn, which is, like, the most expensive Bomberman game out there. And for good reasons, because it supports, like, 16-player... 16... Saturn Bomberman allows 16 players at once. The only other... I think there's, like, one that does 32 players or something. 32 bombers or something. There's some crazy projects that they had. Yeah, Saturn... I think it's only on online play, but it's either that or you can actually hook up, like... I know you can... There's something called a multi-tap, like a Bomberman tap thing for Super Nintendo, even, where you can... but that's for, I think, four control... Because there's only two plugs, right? So you can do four-player Bomberman with the multi-tap. But I don't know if they have a multi-tap for Saturn to where you can do 16 players on console. That's crazy. Yeah, you can have the whole... That's badass, I think.
Whoa!
I would love to have a fucking multi-tap for Bomberman and then bring that to GDQ and have Zelda fucking get his ass handed to him in a multiplayer Bomberman.
Yeah.
I saw that Marvel Ball Gold Platinum one was kind of shaky there, Zelda. What do you
think? Yeah, well, yeah. No comment, huh?
No comment. you were thinking about Chrono Trigger and how you should be playing that instead, there, Zelda? Now, I came in here because I wanted to talk to Blunt, but his ass went straight to bed, and I'm like, fuck. And then I was just hanging out in here ever since. In Discord.
Talking to Blunt.
Well, because he has his thing on Friday, and he wants me to commentate, so I...
Oh, it's Friday?
Yeah, it's, like, literally tomorrow morning, and it's, like, it's, like, literally 24 hours from now. Like...
Oh, yeah, so it's, like, at the ass o'clock.
Which is why I'm staying up tonight, to get ready, because I'm going to stay up all night tomorrow, too, just to catch it.
What's the Twitch for the run?
I don't even know. I have the Discord for it. You know, it's like... Who is it? Hikage or something is hosting it on Foos something? I don't even know.
I'll just ask one.
Yeah.
It would be funny if he'd say, like, I don't even know where it's going to be streamed at.
I don't even know if he does, honestly. He said, oh, well, they'll give it to you when you're in the Discord. They'll just give you the stream.
I'm just gonna go in there and, roll deep.
but I'm gonna comment. I guess he's got Overfiend on commentary for. He's got Overfiend on commentary for Donkey Kong Country 3 that he's doing as well. And he's actually going to be there. So we're going to hear some we're going to hear some exclusive Overfiend commentary that after he hasn't been around for a long time. That's going to be pretty intense.
Maybe we can use a few of his comments for, you know, future introductions.
Yeah, absolutely. So, you know, when you're using Dixie Kong here and you got Kitty Kong and...
A tremendous amount of damage.
Tremendous amount of time save here. Yeah, I buy import games. I just picked up Bomberman Jetters for the Japanese version for GameCube, but I can't play it because my fucking disc reader isn't working. And I have to fucking go to the post office today whenever I wake or whatever and return a shitty one that I got, so that's gonna be fun. Alright, we are getting somewhere with this run. Hopefully I don't fucking blow the exit up or what did I do there? Did I blow up the item? Because there's no way I blow up the I must have blown up the item. I don't think so. Is this not all items? Do you have to collect them? I'm not. Can somebody confirm for me? I can't look. And should I just reset now? What's an all items run? Do I have to literally collect? And did I just blow one up? So now it's invalid for all. What just happened there? Did I just fuck myself? 25 stages in, 42 minutes in the room. Am I not gonna be? I don't think I can get the eye because I just blew it up, didn't I? God damn it, Overfiend. Can somebody fucking confirm for me before I blow my fucking brains out here? I missed an item, god damn it. Because I blew it up. I don't know if that counts for us. Someone fucking confirm? Is it okay to blow up items? Yeah, what is collecting one of each item? What the hell is that? You can't even see how many bombs you have, let alone like what items to fucking collect. And the sad thing is, the other run that I got to stage fucking 44 collected them all. And now we already fucked it up on 22 or whatever this is. Cause I think that that's invalid now to myself because I missed an item and it didn't. You hear the jingle when you collect the item, so I didn't hear it on that level, so that means I missed one. Like, does it mean each step? I don't even fucking know, man. The rules are just fucking. Don't make any sense. Well, yeah, I mean, it was off screen. I mean, I got it, I guess. But there was no audio cue. I just want a goddamn all items, all blocks run complete. And I was fucking 7 levels away, and then I enter the fucking door and miss all the blocks and all that. Like, I just fucked it up earlier, and I probably just fucked it up again. Yeah, I'm gonna keep going, and we're just gonna roll with it, because it's probably an item I didn't need anyway, but even then, I like to collect them all anyway. Games piss me off. And to think that I actually have to do this in Bomberman 2 as well. Oh my god. I think I'm gonna dub over DBZ over this because the gameplay is just boring. Well, I guess, I mean, blowing up the item, I think, is still fine, personally, but is like, as long as you don't leave the item, I guess, on the screen, I don't know. But there's that jingle that you get when you collect an item on the stage, and I didn't get it, so... There's one stage without that, motherfucker. Like, there's no bomb, like, in, at least in Party Edition, you have a bomb count and a fire count, so you know, you can confirm, okay, I had all 10 bombs that I could have collected. This one, you can't even really, like, how does someone say, oh yeah, he's got 10 bombs, like, how do you know? How can you confirm that? And that's why I would say all items is collecting them all on each, and I just blew one up, like a fucking idiot, pissing me off.
Well, I'll be right back in a few minutes. Gonna do some push-ups.
Yo, push-ups.
Busting out the grips.
All right, and did you get those push-ups in? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I have 9. So I guess I just need one more bomb upgrade, and I guess you have to have 5 firepower, which I don't even know if I have or not. And then I guess you gotta get the fire, like, I don't know what the fucking requirements are, honestly. It's not clear to me. Yeah, I mean, I had the one, and even then, like, you run out, there's a point where you can't even collect more bombs, so the only thing I don't have is one bomb upgrade, I guess, and then one fire upgrade, I guess. Unless that, if that was a fire upgrade and there's no other one, then I guess I could be screwed, but I may not. I find it that you have to collect every item on each level and hear the jingle, but, you know, I didn't hear it there because I fucking blew it up, but... Blowing it up, I guess, is sort of the same thing, because you get the item, I guess, and then the map's... Like, I guess it's just map completion, but that's... Again, that's not all items, really, so I don't... It's a weird fucking thing that's really not really explained well. But I guess this is pretty much legit, and there really wasn't anything I could do there. It blew up like a fucking... for no reason. But I went all 44 stages last time without... with getting the jingle every level. and making it, and then I fucked that up. That's just fucking tore me apart, man. All I wanted to do was finish that run. Like, I could have just finished that run like 3 hours ago. You know, we could have been probably done with Bomberman 2 here as well, and then no more fucking bullshit wall blocks for me, because I've done them all. And this one is substantially shittier than Super Bomberman all blocks, because the screen's so fucking big. This does look faster than the last run, but... So that's, I guess, a good thing, but, just that one stage kind of pissed me off. Because I did want to collect them all, but whatever. I'm gonna get the fire thing soon, and then I'll be a little bit less stressed out. The doors all the way on the left side. All these blocks will take care of them. Pretty quick there. Did you do 2 push-ups? It's gonna...
I did 3 sets of 25.
This isn't looking good here. So in a few levels I get the fireproof item, and then I can just like spam bombs. So like now I think I have full firepower, and then I just need, I guess I have 9 bombs or so. I think I picked up another one though, so I have full bombs. Thank you. Fuck! Why did I do that? Fucking bullshit, man. Kitty, that was fucking bullshit. See, I know I have all the bombs. Like, if there's 10 is the maximum, I knew I had 9, and that's... We would make 10, and I... This is 5 firepower, I believe, so this doesn't get any bigger. So if you're looking at it like that, okay, I've got all... But I just... Something in it just wants to get every fucking item on every fucking... And I fucking... There was one fucking stage... Where I blew up the item. But blowing up the item is essentially getting the item in its own sense. So, I mean... You can look at it however you want to look at it. And I'm totally down with going with the fact that if you blow up the item, it's basically like getting an item. But, I mean... Who knows, man? Just need to make it a few more levels and I'll get the fireproof shit. Thank you. Here we go. Alright, can we make it 20 more fucking stages without any bullshit and we'll just forget about the fact that I blew up on the fucking items? Which, I mean, it's still legit. I have one of each item, so it's not. As far as it specifies, yeah, but. This is all items, all blocks. Isn't that right, Kitty? It's all fucking items, all fucking. I'll just throw some DBZ in the top left corner after this and call it good.
Oh, WQ, back at it.
Nice. I was about to blast that again, and then I'm like, it could be the door, and it was.
Are you ready now to witness a power not seen for thousands of years? I am the Prince of all Saiyans!
Oh, you think the glitch consists of making the game think that you have this upgrade when you don't? Do you think that has something to do with the fact that you can survive in the fire? Because it is a mechanic in the game that they allow you to do that, but you can do it without the power-up if you mash the button. Walt Disney's favorite level, 33. I fucked this one up. I don't know what to say. It always seems to be like the last few, like, it just, I don't know if I just lose concentration or what. It's like, who wants to do all these fucking stages over again? Why would I fucking fuck it up right there? Just dumb. Okay, I found a door and I didn't enter it. That's something, isn't it? It's just... I guess why I can't go crazy with it, because then I'll just enter the fucking door on these last fucking 10 levels, and yeah. So I'm not sure if that other room was even better. I think that might have been on a better pace. I'm not. I think it might have been. Thank you. let's just finish it. Let's just be done with it. It's not fucking. Okay, look at that. I got both the bullshit things out of the way right there. I don't know where the door is, so if I go crazy, I'll fucking walk in the door again like an idiot. So we're just gonna take it a little bit easy here. There we go, now I know where it is. Now I can go crazy. That one was cut off from halfway up. That was weird. That coin was like glitched out. Half of it was not showing. All right, I found the door. That's good. Oh, fuck! Why, damn it. Not paying attention. This wasn't a big deal. I blew up another item, but I guess it doesn't matter. Because I already did that anyway. And we've already established it doesn't really matter. I've got all the items, or one of each item. And I'm clearing the map, so it's like, what else do you want? Did I blow up the item again? I guess so. I didn't see it. Is there no item? I don't even. I'm just losing it. I have definitely not missed a block. So this is definitely all blocks. However, you want to find all items, which I have one of each. If that's really what the circumstances are. So if I would have blown that door up right there, right next to it, and then enemies would have spawned right on top of me, that would have fucking killed me, I'm sure. So it's a good thing that didn't happen. Like, that's why you don't spam, I guess. If you don't know where the door is, it's just, it can be disastrous. Yeah, it would have been cool if I could have gotten sub 130, but I don't see that happening. Like, is there just no item spawns on some of these? I don't even know, because I blew up the door. It's fine though. Because these enemies are really easy to kill. And I know where the door is now, which is good. So does it end on 49? And then 50 is like a bonus or something? I don't even know when to split, honestly. Split at the end of 49 or split at the end of 50, if there even is a 50. Is there a stage 50, or is that just a load runner like bonus thing? I don't know. Well, that was a pretty early door, and it's right in the middle of things as we start this one out. I'm kind of scared because I haven't found the door yet. So it could be anywhere. And I know there's coins on the next three levels, so hopefully you don't just fucking spam in my face. Sub 135, maybe? There's gonna be a coin on this level, I know it. There he is, little bastard. Found the door. Yeah, sub 135 is looking real here if we hurry this down. So basically two levels left, bitch. Levels. Alright, I'm feeling the sub 135. Come on. Let's fucking get it. Well, it's just bonus stage. Maybe not. If this is... It's not gonna be a sub 135 because of the bonus stage. Let's get these coins out of the way. There's two of them. Show them what's good. Well, sub 135 was looking real, but that bonus stage was too much. So I don't want to blow the exit up and then have like enemies spawn. So let's just take it easy here. I've got the bullshit out of the way, the coins are gone. Found the door so we know where not to fucking go until the end. Now I could still like blow up the item and then have it. Okay, we got it. Now it's just basically just destroy the boss. Sub 136? Yeah, sub 136 for sure. rolling deep.
He becomes load runners.
Alright, well, thanks for watching. That was,
I did it!
It was the OG 1985 Japanese Bomberman. All blocks and one of each item. Rolling deep with a 135-41. I will go to all stages and whatever, you know, do try the any percent out, but thanks for watching. This is the RP motherfucking G. Rolling deep.